Hello, everybody, and welcome. My name is Cvetan Uzunov. I am from Olimex, and today I will talk about one of our projects or attempt to make a completely open source hardware laptop, and to do this with KiCad. So, Olimex is a small company in Bulgaria, already 27 years old. We do some electronic designs, development tools, programmers, small Linux computers, and we have about 600 products which we have been developing during the time, and half of them are open source hardware. All this happened about 2 years ago when I saw in my house a pile of laptops. And all of these laptops had some issues, some very small issues. Some just got obsolete because they have no enough RAM to run modern operating system, or they had slow processor. But anyway, it was huge pile of laptops, and I thought to myself that this must have some simple solution. And what I started thinking of is a laptop with the modular design. So when some part gets obsolete, you don't throw away the whole laptop, you just change the motherboard or the detail which is obsolete. For instance, in this pile I had a laptop with a broken LCD or with a dead battery, or just a power supply jack is with some problem. But the manufacturer made them totally unrepairable. Everything put on single board. If you broke your LCD, the new LCD cost almost like a half new laptop. And you think for yourself, why to repair this laptop for the half price? I will just get new one. And this is exactly what they want you to do. So I thought that we might design a laptop which is totally open source, so everybody can tailor to his own taste, to his needs, to be modular design, still to be with elegant shape, so not to be looking like a brick. To be easy to assemble, because part of the fun is to assemble this laptop by yourself. So you know every bit of your laptop. If something breaks, you have source for low-cost spare parts, and you just exchange this part which has broken, nothing else. Also, I wanted it to be small, and to be light, so you can carry with yourself, and the battery has to long as much as possible. Later this idea involved to, why not to add to this laptop some kind of laboratory functionality. So you get this laptop and you have inside the laptop digital storage oscilloscope, component tester, and logic analyzer. So this is how it started. It was November 2015, and the whole process took about 2 years. Why so long? Because this project split to many other smaller projects. First, we had to source good plastic for the laptop, because we knew electronics, but we don't know mechanics. We cannot draw the plastics, we cannot do this. So obviously I had to find something which is available on the market in which I can convince the buyer to purchase. So I can use like a base for the laptop which we will design. Then we had to select different LCD, because it appears that the laptops don't use the normal parallel RGB signals LCDs. They use EDP mostly, because they need less signals, and they can be made with the tiny cables which pass through the hinges of the laptop. So we had to, of course, select the main processor, SoC. And actually, this job for the laptop turned out that we had to design several other boards to evaluate different components which we intended to use in the laptop design. One of these is the Allwinner A64 SoC. At that time, it was pretty new to the market, and I decided that it might be a good idea to implement the laptop with it. Then we had to make another design with the FPGA to might implement the oscilloscope and the logic analyzer. We made fast ADC and DAC modules, EO modules, and et cetera, and et cetera. So it took us 2 years because we had basically to design many, many different other boards to may evaluate, to make several revisions of each of these boards while we achieve some good results, which could be useful. Around August 2016, we already had few prototypes to show on one local conference, TuxCon, which is in Plovdiv, where Olimex is located. So this is where we proudly presented the laptop with the very first prototypes of the PCBs. February, we already had the working hardware on FOSDEM. We had a table. Some of you may remember, they passing by. And the hardware was working, but the software was in totally useless shape. So, so it kind of worked, but absolutely not as we wanted to see it working. A lot of things changed since then. And in October, we started actually to the sales. We built very small initial batch of 100 laptops because I was afraid to go with some higher number. We didn't know what to expect because you test everything, and the feedback was very good because it appeared that we still missed some few corner cases. One of these, for instance, was the LCD backlight. On some LCDs, in some conditions, one inductor started to resonate on some very high harmonic, and it was hearable. The LCD backlight works on 300 hertz, but you can hear visible sound around 1 kilohertz because we assembled just, I don't remember, 5 or 6 laptops, because we made 100 laptops. We couldn't assemble them all to check if they work, because the fun was people to assemble the laptop by themselves. So we, for Murphy Law, all of the laptops we built had not this issue. But when we shipped 100 boards to 100 laptops to the customers, few of them complained about this sound. So we had to think about patching and so. Another issue was with the touch screen, with the touch panel buttons, because we have lack of GPIOs. We used ADC and put some resistor dividers, which has been 5%. So, let's say about 2% of the of the laptops we shipped, some people have started to complain that when they press left button, they read right button, and vice versa. This was fixed with 1% resistor later, but it was again some corner case we missed. So where we are now? Software-wise, we still have Ubuntu with Mate in usable state, but it's not optimal solution. I hope, I think Igor is somewhere here, that soon we will have mainline support for A4064, and we will have Armbian with mainline Linux. As a hardware, the minute we release the board, some people started asking, can we have more memory? Can we have faster processor? So again, a good tip from Armbian member was to look after RK3328, which will allow up to 4 GB of RAM. One of the most asking questions was, can I have the 3D models for the plastic? Because I want to change the keyboard to French layout. I want to change the keyboard to German layout. I want to make something else. And the problem is that we actually didn't have these files because we just buying the plastics. But fortunately, some of the people who bought laptop, they start reverse engineering the plastic and they start making this. And this is one US customer who didn't like the way these cables on. Basically, this is the most trickiest part when you assemble the laptop. There are many tiny wires and you have to place them in exact position. Otherwise, it doesn't snap so well. So he made his own version where he's assembling the laptop much easier than our original design. And then I blog about this, and one Bulgarian company contacted us and say, okay, we can 3D scan this plastic part because this is what we are doing for a living, and we saw that you have problems. So I guess we will have soon 3D models for all the plastic parts, and people really can start changing them up to their needs. This is what we are doing now. We integrated Sigrok in the image. So you can see here the laptop is working as an oscilloscope and digital logic analyzer. And you can put some complex triggering in the Sigrok to catch signals. It's still on prototype stage, but I hope in a couple of months we will have something almost finished, like a module which you can put inside the laptop and turn it into the laboratory tool. So when we start working on the laptop, it was natural choice to start working with to make it with KiCad. And for us was very important to have open source tool to make this open source project, because you cannot use Altium and to say to your to the people, yeah, buy this tool for 8,000 euro and you can open the design files and you can see and tailor them. This just doesn't work. And in this case, we have some insight to share. What we are doing is we always use the latest builds. Why? Because if you use these latest builds, you don't have to come to the FOSDEM to see the new features in the KiCad, because you know them. We work with this new library manager for months. We didn't saw this Eagle import, but it's who cares about it? But the problem is that Ubuntu and Windows binary are lagging way behind because they are considered some stable version, which is maybe 1 year old. And usually people download, install Ubuntu binaries or download Windows binaries. Okay, I cannot open your laptop files with this. I cannot open these files. And we start asking, yeah, please go use the latest builds, you will have to access. So maybe we should think about some way this daily builds to be available for Windows and for Ubuntu, normal Ubuntu users, with the remark that it's unstable version and they can use it on their own risk. We can provide, for instance, a machine when these deployments to happen. Of course, when you work with the latest builds, you always have to be cautious when you install the new versions. Although the only problem we have seen for the last 2 years was with this library upgrade. We installed the new version in. We couldn't open our work from yesterday. And the guy who first installed, they say, stop, guys, don't install on the other computers because I already have no access to the files. So you have to make sure that you work with some virtual machine, or first try the new installation on the virtual machine, and when you everything is sure that it works, then to install it to the other machines. And the other major problem with the laptop is they download from GitHub the files and they say it searched for some libraries. When KiCad opens the files, it says I cannot find library for these components. They are inside the design. They are cached in the library, but KiCad still complains that cannot find them in the normal library ways. And this confuses especially beginners who don't know what they are doing. And they say again, oh, maybe Olimex didn't upload their libraries or something intentionally, so I cannot open these files. So maybe some workaround when you save your project in some folder, put inside all the libraries and all things, and if you find everything there, just don't complain that you don't find it in the normal library path, because they are there. And to summarize, this was one of the most interesting project we have been working about. Now I have in my hands laptop, which was the dream machine for me. It does exactly what I wanted from it, and it has all the features I wanted to see. And it's a template base for all other peoples to make their own version if they don't like this. So it's everything is available. Soon the plastic will be available, so everybody will be able to customize it up to his own need. Many people love this laptop, and they really help with the software updates. Most of the software testing was done by our community. People who bought the laptop, even in our forum, they made a parallel laptop image. One of them made a Gentoo distribution, who I don't know who works with, but it's available if somebody wants to build a Gentoo for the laptop. It's available. So if there are some questions. What we will do different in the next version in the laptop? Well, we already working on more memory, more RAM. Just Allwinner A64 cannot address more than 3 GB, and to find DDR with 24 gigabit is very difficult. It's probably just for the mobile phone or smartphone or something like this. I don't know if you follow the market on the memories, but for the last 3 years, the price is just triple. And I read that maybe 1.5 billion smartphones has been built last year, and this is where those memories are going, and it's crazy. If you find memory, just buy it and stock it. It's a 4 million phones every day.
Sorry, I don't know if you addressed this. How much does it cost?
How much the laptop costs? It's 240 euro, and it comes as a kit. You build it yourself.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. How long does it support? For example, the screen is broken in 5 years.
How long we will support it? We will support it as long as we can. for the main boards and for the electronics, I'm sure that we will always have these boards. Even if they are not with the current processor, we will just move to a new processor and we will LCD. If this is not the current LCD, if there is a new LCDs with bigger resolution, with brightest backlight, we will just add support for the new LCD. So there will be always these spare parts for the laptop. If something breaks, we use this laptop by ourselves also. So
we have many questions. Yeah, one here, and then you.
Okay. For example, if I want to build a 14-inch version of this, I guess you have EDP connection.
Yeah. So yeah. EPD. So it's just a matter of running new script, repeating questions. If you want to, the question was what happened if I want to use another LCD with different resolution or different size or different features. EDP standard allows you to connect any other LCD with the EDP standard on it. So it's just a matter of configuration in the Linux. What is the current situation? Fortunately, this is A53, so it's not affected by this.
Yes.
What bootloader do you use for the machine?
What bootloader do we use? U-boot.
Yeah. Is it mainline U-boot or is some?
I don't know.
No, it's not mainline.
No, not mainline.
It's a legacy. U-boot.
How close is the laptop from certification by FSF? I don't know, because I never search for the requirements. But I guess we pass because we open everything. So.
Okay, I propose three quick questions. You and you.
To address the keycard.
Fourth, okay.
The keycard concerns. There are daily builds for
yes.
Ubuntu binaries.
Yes. Basically, we use Ubuntu binaries, but the Ubuntu repository keeps some binary from maybe a year or maybe more than a year.
No, there's a PPA for.
Yeah, there is a PPA, but if you use the standard Ubuntu repository, which most people do, they don't go to the KiCad org and they don't include these repositories to their.
So my question is, what do you need from KiCad? No, I mean, that's not in the stable version.
I don't need anything from the KiCad. We can handle this, but they maybe have to think about mostly Windows users because they lack a lot. Ubuntu users, they build. For instance, we had a workshop. We made a workshop for KiCad. We're trying to teach community how to use the KiCad. And I think Rangel came with Arch. He had to build everything from the from the sources. So we are showing how to use KiCad and half day he is compiling KiCad. But if you use Ubuntu, you have no problems with.
Okay, please, quick questions. We're lagging behind.
How do you plan to handle all the hardware configurations which will accumulate over time, like different screens, different boards, different stuff?
It's a matter of scripts. How do we think to keep the different configuration which will be available later with different SOC, different screens, different...
So device three overlays or something like that?
Maybe. We don't have this problem so far. So.
Do you have a stand here where we can try this out, or just
here on FOSDEM? No, we don't have stand.
Buy one. I mounted mine with my kids over a rainy weekend, and they loved it. last question, Tom.
I didn't want to ask.
Oh, sorry. So any
we have a slightly more high.
Okay. So any last question? Yeah.
So how is the possibility of separating the SOC as a separate breakout board?
Yeah, it is. It is separated. It's a main board with the SoC with the memories, and the EOS and keyboard and other stuff is on different modules. So when you want to change SoC, you just change this board with the SoC. We don't change other. This is why we did it modular. Great.
Okay, how many people do we can have questions? Like, there's a lot of people. Okay. let's do 1, 2, 3 more questions. Yeah.
Okay. So in terms of actually using KiCad to design this, what were the biggest pain points? What were the biggest problems you had?
We started using KiCad maybe 4 years ago. And at that time, I will say that we had to save our work every half hour. People who use it, KiCad. But KiCad now is totally different state. I don't remember to have any problems for the last 2 years except this library change, which was a big surprise, but it was fixed for maybe a couple of days. I don't remember. But it was very nervous couple of days because we work on something and we have to stop working because we don't know what will happen.
May I?
Yes.
So why not mainline U-boot? Why do you think with
the guy behind you is... Yeah. Remember, we started.
Okay, last one.
Did you have any issues running high-speed signals
No, absolutely not.
Okay.
Actually, it was very funny because Javier, when we started working with KiCad seriously, he said. Yeah, you know, you're making very complex boards, and all people in CERN are still not confident in KiCad, and they don't want to use KiCad for serious stuff. And this is why I got one laptop now, and I will give to Javier so he can show to his colleagues what can be done with KiCad.
Too late, I bought one.